Lynetta Burton's love for reading.
I would not be the educator I am without her.
And her passion for students that prompted her colleague Dominique Mitchell to create this lending library.
It hit me that I had to make the library in honor of Miss Burton.
Monday morning, Mrs. Burton was welcomed to school with her big retirement surprise.
It warmed my heart because she saw in me that I had a love for reading for the children, and then that was to honor my time at Pleasant Grove.
Students will be able to access the book barn all summer long. They're able to take any of the books out of here to add to their own personal collections at home.
Dominique tells us resources are slim for students in this area, so this library gives them easy access to books, and it also recognizes the person who pushes the students the most to read.
I wanted something, of course, that would be about her, but it needed to really be about what she's all about, and that's reading.
Mrs. Burton's career at Pleasant Grove started back in the 80s.
I think God placed me here.
She came determined to give back to students who lived in the same county that gifted her with one of her first loves. And after 38 years, it's time for Mrs. Burton to finish a chapter in life.
Well, I've cried, and I've thought about all of the things that I have accomplished here at Pleasant Grove Elementary School, and all of the families that I've touched, and the educators that I've touched. So I feel like I've had a rewarding career.
And this book barn will forever stand in memory of her legacy. In Alamance County, Olivia Steen, Fox 8 News.
And Pleasant Grove is encouraging